G'day guys, welcome back to BMTroubleU. Today we're going to do the water pump recall on this Mini. The additional turbocharger coolant pumps have been going a bit wrong lately in these BMWs and Minis, so we're going to get this thing up in the air and we'll check it out and I'll show you how to bring it out. Alright guys, here we are underneath this Mini. From the underneath, the coolant pump is that black component just there. It sort of bolts in underneath the oil to coolant heat transfer on the left there. I'm going to pull that puppy out. You also have to drain the coolant for this thing. So we're going to take off two lines and a plug connection and two 10 mil bolts, I think they are, or 10 or 8 mils. We'll have a look. Alright guys, step number one is going to be taking off this bottom hose, draining the coolant. Just a bit of pair of pliers, just take that clamp off and we'll get a pick just to break the seal. I usually like to get a pick in here without damaging the hose obviously and just run it up and down just like that and eventually pry it loose. Have a drain ready, some sort of container, just like this one, pull that out. Bit messier than I would have liked it, but anyway. When you're draining the coolant, I also like to drain it from the heater core, which is the two black hoses up here that go into the firewall. That involves a pick as well. Should just be able to pick at the back here. There's a little connector. You just take the little, actually this one, probably the bottom one would be better. Take that off. See that little black clip? And we'll pull that out as well. Much more messy than I would have liked it, but that's the way it goes. On to the next step. To make it a bit easier for you guys, I've got the brand new pump here, just to illustrate to you what I'm trying to do. That 3-pin connector we've got to pull off. The oxygen sensor wiring comes through these two. You've got to pull the oxygen sensor wiring out of those. And the two bolts go in here. Pretty sure they're 8 mils. Right in there, and up here, that's the plug for the oxygen sensor wiring. You got to be careful pulling that out because I've busted that a few times. And obviously, yeah, two hoses, and just the tension clamps on those. So we're gonna try and do that on the car now. All right, my weapon of choice for this, guys, is gonna be some long needle nose pliers, and to just bring the clamp and the hose out as one, just like that, wiggle them back and forth. There you go, that's number one. Let that drain out, that's the bottom one. The upper one I like to get with a pair of bent nose pliers. Just here. Guys, it takes a bit of true grit to get these last bits done. It's 2 8-mils. One of them you can only see by using the force, as seen in Star Wars. All mechanics will probably know what I'm talking about here. You can only feel the bolt, you can't actually see it. I've got my 1/4 inch with a small extension and an 8-mil on the end of it. And I'm right on the head of that bolt. Well, I wasn't a second ago anyway. That's my weapon of choice there. That's just enough to get it. I usually crack them and then I'd undo them with my drill, which is really handy. The Bosch IXO got a 90 degree angle bit, you can get right in there. The first one is right there, you can see it just hanging out if you've got good eyes. And one right down the back here, that plug connector has come out. It was right here. Just push down on the back of it where the wires come in. That little bit there. Push down on the back of that. Pull out. That's the only thing that holds that in. And this up here needs a trim removal tool for that bit of the plug. See this black section up here? You just yank that out, straight out it is. There we go, we've got the old pump out. That's the new pump we're going to put in. Those are the two 8mm across here. Turns out my trusty Bosch IXO was unsuccessful getting the left hand side out. Right hand side was no worries, just crack that off and drill it out. Turn that drill. Saved me some time, but this one is a fingertips job. You got to get up here like this and just get your fingertips onto it and just give it a bit of that. Alright, we'll put the new one in. Take these caps off, obviously. And chuck that in. So just again, that's oxygen sensor wiring. 2 8mm, a plug. There's a plug that's held into there, a little sort of raw plug clip, and 2 hoses. Alright, we'll do that now. That's the hole that came out of, guys. You can see those 2 empty threads just in the oil filter housing there. That's where we're going to be chucking it back in. You can see the cutout. That also corresponds to the cutout on here. Alright. The mechanics trick I'm going to use here, guys, just in case you're unaware. Always keep a stash of blue tack on the box. And I just stuck a bit of blue tack in there. That's going to hold my left hand side bolt on so I can just hold it square and run it in with my fingers. Because you can get your fingers in there and balance the pump and do everything else, it's a bit hard. So we'll do that now. Alright, guys, you see the left hand side bolt in here? I'll give you a demonstration of my drill in action. Little champion. Snip that up by hand. 90 degree angle in there. That's the one you can see. Straight through those 2 black sections there. Alright, we've got both those bolts in. Put the hoses on. We've plugged the plug in. The blue connector up there. Push that back onto the plate. And run the wiring back into those clips for the oxygen sensor. One thing I do to make it a bit easier to reinstall these things, guys, is just move that hose clamp so that you can get at it from the bottom with a pair of long nose pliers, because initially you've got to come in this way and it sort of impinges on the exhaust here. So I just move that down to the bottom so you can come straight through from the bottom, straight up, get onto that clamp if it's easy as, and chuck it on. Top one's already on, I'm just going to move that clamp down onto the motor. Alright guys, finished product. You've got your hose clamp back on your bottom hose. You got your 2 hoses on, all your plugs in routed wiring. Alright guys, that's the very end of it. The coolant system is properly drained, filled and bled with our BMW system. That's how you replace a additional coolant turbocharger coolant water pump on a Mini. I'll soon do one on a BMW as soon as I get one in. And I'll catch you next time on BMTroubleU.